Sorry, Mejzlik.
Hi guys, this is Lauren from Tighter Robotics. Today we're running some tests to see if theory translates into practice for one-bladed propellers. We're aiming to see if one-bladed props truly are the most efficient. We also want to see the impact on thrust and RPM of losing one blade. Finally, we're going to balance the one-bladed propeller using our dynamic balancer. Stay tuned for our results. First off, we need to make our one-blade propeller. The folks at Mejzlik kindly sent us a set of 16-inch propellers with special permission to chop one of them up. We used a Dremel to cut one of the blades off our experimental prop, leaving enough room to drill a hole where we would place our counterweight. In an ideal world, we would have had the single blade prop custom manufactured for better aerodynamics, but for this experiment, we decided to work with what we had in-house.
Sorry, Mejzlik.
Next, we balance the single blade propeller. We first used a static balancer to approximate how many washers we would need on our bolt counterweight. Then we refined it with a dynamic balancer built into the Flystand 15 thrust stand. With the dynamic balancing software feature, we can achieve ISO quality balancing in just a few spins with easy to follow instructions at each step. We were aiming for a quality grade of 6.3, but couldn't quite reach it despite numerous corrections. The Flystand 15 measures vibration to evaluate the quality of the balancing, so it could be that the aerodynamic effects of the bolt influence the results, that the axial position of the counterweight requires two plane balancing, or that the unbalanced thrust is simply creating noise in the measurements. 6.99G is still very good, so we'll move on with the experiment. In comparison, the two-blade propeller achieved a passing quality grade of 5.55G without any modifications. After balancing the propellers, we confirmed their respective weights, 29 grams for the single-blade propeller and 18 grams for the two-blade propeller. At the end of the video, we will have a discussion on how this difference and other variables may have affected our results. Now it's time to put the propellers to the test. Using the Flystand software, we designed and ran an automated step test with 5 throttle steps, which allowed us to collect performance data across a wide range of operating points. We were most interested in finding out how the propellers compared in terms of thrust and efficiency, and answering the ultimate question, are single-bladed props truly more efficient? First off, we wanted to look at how the RPM compared between the two props. At the same throttle values, the RPM was practically identical. Since the load applied by the two propellers is quite different, this suggests that our ESC controls RPM in a closed loop. Next, we can look at the thrust generation of the two propellers. At the same RPM, the thrust output of the two-blade propeller was significantly higher than the single-blade propeller. This result is unsurprising, as the two-blade propeller has nearly double the lift-producing area as a single-blade prop. The difference becomes increasingly pronounced as RPM increases. Now let's get into the good stuff, efficiency. The results were actually pretty surprising, and you'll see why in just a second. But I'll just take a moment to say that if you're enjoying this video, we invite you to like it and subscribe to our channel. Here at Tighter, we're very passionate about propulsion testing, and it means the world to us that you're engaging with our content. So thank you. Now, where were we? Yes, efficiency. In this video, we are calculating propeller efficiency in terms of grams of force of thrust generated per watt of mechanical power, the product of torque and RPM. This isn't a typical unitless way of characterizing efficiency, but it provides an intuitive way of evaluating propulsion system performance when dealing with VTOL aircraft like drones. So how do the propellers compare? When we plot propeller efficiency against RPM, we can see that at all rotation speeds, the single-blade propeller is more efficient than the two-blade propeller. This agrees with the theory that single-blade props are the most efficient. However, if we are comparing possible propellers for the same drone, we don't really care about the RPM at which they rotate, as long as it's reasonable. What we care about is whether the propellers can generate the thrust we need and how efficiently they operate when generating that thrust. And that's what we have in the graph here. As you can see, when we plot propeller efficiency against thrust, the single-blade propeller only maintains superior efficiency at lower thrust. At about 0.2 kgf of thrust, the two-blade propeller starts to exhibit higher efficiency. In the future, it would be nice to gather more data to extend each dataset a bit further to get more overlap, but for now, our power law fit can help us predict values beyond our measured data. Now, we're the first to admit that this experiment wasn't perfect, with just a few confounding factors, some of which we've mentioned below. Notably, as you can probably tell, the modified single-blade propeller was not very streamlined, which likely had a negative effect on its thrust and efficiency performance. Additionally, our test stand is mounted on a mobile cart with fencing surrounding the propeller. This undoubtedly has an impact on the aerodynamics and propeller performance, though we are fairly confident that the impact is consistent across tests. Furthermore, the motor we used for this experiment was likely a bit oversized for the propellers being tested. Since we are measuring torque and mechanical power, this has no effect on the validity of the result. However, if we were designing this for a real drone, we would use the same propellers on a smaller motor in order to operate in the motor's peak efficiency zone. Finally, in this experiment, we focused on running the propellers through the exact same test, rather than comparing them in equal performance indicators. In a future experiment, it could be interesting to focus on achieving the same thrust with a single and two-blade propeller, either by operating at different RPMs or by comparing blades with different shapes and sizes but similar outputs. Despite these confounding factors, we hope that you enjoyed this comparison of single and two-bladed propeller performance. If you'd like to learn more, you can check out the full article on our website, which goes into even deeper detail into single-blade propeller theory and provides additional data comparing overall powertrain efficiency. And if you have any questions or suggestions for future tests, just leave us a comment below. Thanks for watching.